If you've ever looked into applying filters or processing to your microphone, there's a very good chance that you've come across something called a limiter or a compressor. In this video, we wanted to provide you with a starting point on how to use a compressor or limiter in Wavelink for your microphone channel. A compressor is designed to reduce the volume of loud audio and bring up quiet sections to create a flatter sound profile. For the purposes of this video, we're looking at the compressor included with the popular and free ReaFir VST2 plugin bundle, linked down in the description. To start out with, threshold is when the compressor begins to take action. Often, for a voiceover, I average around negative 12 dB when speaking, and commonly peak around negative 6 to negative 4 dB. For that reason, I will generally use a threshold around negative 18 decibels, or dB. This can be a good starting point when you're experimenting. Next up is ratio. With a compressor's ratio, you can clamp down on the audio harder or softer depending on how far it goes past the threshold. At 1:1, it's not applying any compression. For every decibel that enters the compressor, one comes out. But as you raise the ratio, the more it tries to clamp down on that audio signal. For example, at 2:1, for every 2 decibels the audio goes over the threshold, the compressor will output 1 decibel. As you may expect, higher ratios will have stronger reactions. As context, this video's audio is processed with a 4:1 ratio, but try giving 3:1 a try. The lower the ratio, the more natural the sound will be. Higher ratios will feel more processed. Next, we have some of the time adjustments. These are generally to taste, so it's good to experiment. Attack is how long the compressor waits after audio passes the threshold before reaching full processing. Release is how long the compressor takes to turn off completely after audio drops below the threshold. Try out something like 5 milliseconds for attack and 50 milliseconds for release for voiceover. Lastly is something known as makeup gain. A compressor and limiter are designed to prevent a signal from reaching high volumes, or at least reducing that volume. As a result, the audio signal will in fact be quieter. Makeup gain can be used to bring some of that volume back to the signal and bring it back to relatively normal audio levels. In the case of the ReaFir compressor, you can use the wet mix control on the right side to adjust the makeup gain. Next, the limiter. A limiter is similar to a compressor, but you can think of it as one with a very high or nearly infinite ratio, and it often doesn't have controls for attack or release. It provides a relatively hard cap of how loud audio can be. In this case, we're looking at the plugin called Loud Max. There are certainly lots of different limiters out there, but ultimately they'll usually have one control that you adjust, the threshold, just like the compressor. A limiter for your wave microphone or wave XLR won't necessarily be as helpful though, since they have clip guard built in. But a compressor could still be beneficial. One way to think about compressors is like brakes on a car. Threshold is when you begin to apply the brakes. Ratio is how hard you apply them. A limiter is more like driving into a wall to stop the car. It's a tad more abrupt. But of course, like with most things in audio, it's down to personal preference. There are some other controls and concepts here which don't necessarily apply or are a bit too complicated to explain, but these are the basics to get you started experimenting. We'll also link to some other resources in the description below the like button, which can help explain some of these aspects further. As a final summary, you would typically use a compressor to gently flatten an audio signal. Besides the aesthetic difference of just liking how it sounds, this can also help you come through clear on smaller speakers or mobile devices without a viewer needing to adjust volume as often. A limiter, on the other hand, can be used as a sort of safety measure on audio channels carrying voice chat or game audio, and can make sure that the sound doesn't spike above a certain volume. Using the threshold, you can directly cap how loud an audio signal can become and prevent blowing out speakers or ears. If you're new to Wavelink and unsure how to add VSTs or audio effects to your channels, check out our setup guide, which is also linked in the description as well. To learn more about how to get the most out of your Elgato products, subscribe to us at youtube.com/Elgato Workshop.